G'day everybody, here we are today just kicking off a new Let's Play series, and we're going to try something that I have never done before. Hopefully that'll be a bit of fun for you as much as it will be for me, and that's a procedurally generated arc. And here, if you want to pause, are my settings. All I did was hit reset to default and then I hit randomize 5 times, so these are the settings I'm using. And I've just called it PG Arc Adventure. Now, I do have six mods installed. Structures Plus, because that's the way Arc should be in the first place. I have a kibble table, because you've seen people make farms and make kibble and cork and blah, blah, blah. I don't want to deal with it. You don't want to deal with it. We just want to get on with the business of playing the game. Bulk crafters, so that we can obviously make stuff in bulk. Resource stacks, just because it makes it easier for things to handle. And because this map will be totally unfamiliar to me, I've included Death Helper and Pet Finder. So that's it, really just quality of life stuff. It's nothing OP. The difficulty is set to 5, so in theory we should have max 150 level dinos, and we are not going to do any cuts. We're not going to do any editing. We're not going to go, oh quick, cut that bit out. None of that. We are just simply going to carry on, and we will pick up the next episode where we finish the last, and we'll play for as long as I find it interesting. Now, I have a couple of aims for the series. Firstly is I want to uncover the whole map, and secondly is I'd like to get a decent base going. So you already know I like to build. You may or may not already have seen the castle. If you haven't, check out my other videos. Don't forget, while you're there, leave a like, share with your friends, invite them to like the channel as well. And if you have any suggestions for any games that you would like me to play, any adventures you'd like me to take part in, if you want me to come and take part in your adventure, just leave a message down below and we'll chat. Okay, so we're just waiting for it to generate the terrain. It does say that the first occasion it does take longer, because it's working out where the mountains go, where the water goes, so yeah, that will take a little bit of processing time. I have a fairly good computer. If anybody wants to know specs, please leave a request. But aside from that, all you need to know is it can probably keep up with whatever we're going to throw at it. And I can probably keep talking for as long as this keeps generating. As I said, no cuts, my apologies. Do check out my other videos. I have a Let's Play series going for The Sims 4, and in the future we're going to be doing some exploring in Second Life. For those of you who haven't heard of Second Life, watch the channel, because we will be including details on how you can take part in that online world as well. Some other games that I have planned to come up is Terra, which I have never played before, so that will be as much an adventure for me as it will for you, laughing at me failing my way forward. We also are going to get into a new Star Wars The Old Republic game. I'm going to play, I have dabbled a bit with it in the past, but I'm going to play a class that I've never played before, so it will all be new for me. I look forward to seeing where we go on our adventure. Now, oh, how exciting, populating my arc. I'm waiting with bated breath. And obviously I have a pre-made L. I'm going to be female. She is not going to be Jane. She is going to be Alara. And I am not going to choose an area. I'm just going to let it spawn me somewhere random. So our first and again, you can check the settings I've got there. Our first aim for this episode is to get somewhere to live. So here we are, looks like snowy trees, and yep, we'll be freezing our butts off any second. Yep, that nasty implant in my arm. Ooh, that's itchy. We'll have a bit of a look around. Very pretty. And we're playing in third person because that's what I like to do. So you can stare at her butt as well. So let's check out the map. We're down here. Okay. We might go this way and go around that headland and see if we can find somewhere that's not so cold. We will grab some plants on the way and hopefully make some clothes. Now, some of the settings I've got on here is XP times 5, because, yeah, basically who wants to wait? We have taming times 10. Harvest is times 5, and our night time is only a quarter of the length of normal, or quarter of a length of the daytime. To harvest trees and bushes that are up against trees, what normally works for me is backing up to the tree or the rock. Don't even go there with your smart comments. And let's work on some fortitude to start with, and some clothes, because we'll be freezing our butts off any second. Backing up to a tree or a rock and hitting E will usually harvest those resources. Now all we're doing is we're going to just run past and collect stuff as we run, because we're not really, I'll hang on to the narco berries because we're wanting to make narcotics in the future, in the not too distant future, I suspect, and we want to get out of this cold area as soon as possible, because no good for survivors, no good for elves. Okay, so we've got Anki's. Let's just check his level as we go past and make sure the difficulty, maybe not. 108 might be still, might not have changed the settings. Let's run past this Archie and hope that he just ignores us. Nope. No. And here's another one. Run, little owl, run. And mammoths and a T-Rex. Yay. Just what we want to see in our first few minutes. Oh, not one T-Rex. Is that two T-Rexes, or is that just a T-Rex chomping on a mammoth? Really, really keen to get out of this cold area. It's two T-Rexes. And there's another one in the distance. Hopefully he won't see me under the water. And we will just keep running. And yeah, he seems to be occupied with those mammoths. It's that one up there I'm more concerned about. Oh, and that one up there. No, you can sod off too, Archie. Yeah, we really need to get out of this cold, so... What do we think? Do you think it'd be wise to go up and over the cross country a bit? Maybe. Might get us into more trouble. Holy crap, what's that? Caught between the rock and a hard place? Three Rexes? I'm not liking this. Oh, jeez. Oh. No. Run between the trees. Use the trees to your advantage. Jeez. I think you might have left us behind. Not stopping to look. Crystal. Good to know. Oh, holy crap. Not deterred. We obviously look like a tasty morsel in his eyes. And... something just ate that mammoth, so I'm not really sure. Wolves. I can't outrun them. All I can hope is that they don't see me. Mammoths, what are they? Probably fending off wolves as well. I'm really not liking this starting in this cold area. Yes, I know I'm... wolves. No! No! Oh. Yep. Alright. We see a large cold biome there. We're not liking the look of it at all. So it's put us in South 1. Let's see. One assumes that these are actually land masses. So let's go down the bottom to West and see what happens there. Oh, bad. What a moment to take a sip of your tea. No. So we ran away from the saber, but there's a rex that I'm hoping the mammoths will kill. Why is there so much ice? Oh, here comes the saber again. That's not gonna happen. Not gonna go well. Yeah, you chase him. That's right. Oxygen, need oxygen. Yeah, snow is not good for us. I mean, sure, we can live in the snow, but it's not what I was hoping for. I was hoping for a little more greenery for us. Oh, hey Rhino, how you doing? Nice to know you. Let's get some clothes, let's get a bit of fortitude. So we can learn the bed. Won't even bother with anything at the moment because we don't have any, no extra engram points. We don't have anything special aside from the mods that we mentioned. And we may have to make a little thatch hut here somewhere very shortly. And it's not going to be T-Rex proof. And we're going to run this way. And hope that he hasn't seen us and that he's sufficiently occupied with mammoths. Jeez. And wolves. And hey, look, I see green stuff in the distance. It's a bit of a long journey to get there, though, I suspect. If we can avoid being spotted by all of the nastiness that hangs out in the cold biomes. Whoa, that looks like a party going on out. No. You just take your bad self out for somewhere else. Dude, fist bump. Okay, so he's quit following. And as long as we don't see a shark. Oh, we're going to be out of stamina any second. How do you back float? Come on, we were all taught at school, swimming lessons, you float on your back to regain your stamina if you're tired while you're swimming. Yeah, right? How does one back lie on their back? Oh, come on. Look, we're nearly close enough to walk, stand, whatever. Just breathe, girl, you'll get through it. Oh, there is a lot of bad stuff here. Yeah. Okay, so still a bit of a distance there. We are not going out to that island because, well, mind you, it looks like the mammoths might have solved all the wolf problems, but we want to try and get somewhere. Does that look like another wolf problem just there? It looks like it to me. See if we can go up this hill a little bit and avoid their sight. Hello! Hello, I like you. You're not going to hurt me. Another 108. What's going on here? Are you the same one that I ran into before? Maybe. Maybe I should have just turned around and looked behind me. Ooh, wolves. Obsidian. Plenty of that around. Good to know. Shires and Brixenhausen, that scared the crap out of me. Breaking wolves. And dead again. Of course. Where did we see? We saw. We might go here. Because that's about, I think, where we saw. No. And here we are running away from. Holy crap. This is not where I expected to be. We might just die to this cat and respawn somewhere else. Thank you. Yes, yay. Oh, look at that. Let's try over in the east and see if we can find some greenery, because that's a oh yes, a lot of snow. Hello, dodos. Hello, parasols. Hello, listeros. So right here, even though there's not a whole lot of greenery around here, it looks like there's plenty for us to make some clothes and. What are you running from? And punch down a few trees so we can make some. Get started on a house. Scorpions. Oh, good. I'm glad to end Dilos. Good, great. Them I can deal with. Come on. Hit the tree. Not hit the. No? What about this one? Are these real trees? These are not real trees? That's a bit of a problem. Or perhaps it's a bit of a noob operating the controls. Alright, let's have a look what we've got in here. Oh, we can make a hat. That'll keep us warm. And we'll steer clear of that Pegamastax as well because we don't really want to give up anything that we've got already. And those little thieving bastards are not getting anything from me. A good tip though is to keep your mejo berries in your zero slot and you may just accidentally tame a Pego. Because they will try and steal what's in your zero slot first, and then next they will look for something in your inventory. So there's my tip for today. Keep mejo berries in your zero slot. You can always eat them if you need them, but yeah, it stops the pegos from stealing anything that you really want to keep. Let's get our clothes on. Let's see if we've got enough to make a pair of pants. We do. Right, let's get some more fortitude going. And we've got, I think we get some thatch going. Foundation would be good. And we want a fire. And a hatchet. And let's see if we can Make a pick. What do we need? Stone. All right, let's see if we can find a bit of stone laying randomly around here. Mostly on the beach, but why aren't these bits of stone? This one. As you can see, 10 times gather. Don't be scaring me and running away from stuff. Right. I can see we're going to have plenty of opportunities for our first flyer tame here, because everybody knows once you hit the skies, you never look back. Maybe not a level 12 though. Jeepers. All right, let's get our pick out. No, we can't call anything. We don't have anything. And get some flint going so we can make an axe. All right. And let's get some trees cleared. I think just in here will be on this top of this rise will be as good a spot as any. So let's take these. Plenty of thatch. Switch to our axe. Get some wood. Jeez, these trees are humongous. Right, let's have a look. Foundations. We can craft one. What are we missing? Fiber. Awesome. Let's just put that. Is a good as place as any. Let's dump some of these berries that and seeds, which we won't need. Stone we will need for the minute because we need and let's get some weight going. And collect some fiber. Get another foundation going. Come on, we just need to make a house and get ourselves into some safety before we finish up this first episode. Thank you. All right. The square box. It's happening. Look at that. How perfect a square platform is that? All right. I think we're lacking some fiber again, so I think this rise here is as good as place as any. We've got a little bit of trees here for shelter and some resources, and not too many plants for fiber, but we will make do with what we've got and get them going as quick as we can. Ah, we didn't want to make 12. Drop. Thank you. Let's make a doorway. Let's make a door, and then let's make some walls. Let's have our doorway facing this way, I think. And some walls. A door. Where's our door? Fantastic. And Okay, so we need, we want a box. Let's get some more weight going. And a spear, and we can forget about, we need a slingshot, narcotics, and, okay. Let's get some, okie dokie. Fiber. We need the fibre. You can go off that way, little Mr. Pegamastax, because I don't want you. Hello, Dodo. We're going to need a bed soon, so once we've got a couple of storage boxes, we might make, let's see, and some slight, want a few more of those. Do the Baywatch war run across the excellent. Let's see. Thatch. We can do. Might leave that big tree up because I quite like them. Oh, shies and bricks and these Pegamastax. Alright. Alright, good enough to finish our house for now. Excuse me, that was just me knocking my microphone. And hey, little Listro, glad to see you. How are you doing? Yeah, good? You head that way? Oh, you've got a missus around here somewhere? Glad to hear it. Everybody needs love, including Listros. And we'll get back into the safety of our four walls, eight walls technically, or seven walls and a doorway. I'm glad we can just step up into it. Let's see, what do we got? Nope. Come on, play the game. Thank you. And our sloped roofs times four. Come on. Now, I know I'm not using the S plus. It doesn't really make any difference at this stage of the game. We will worry about that a bit later on when we have something that we need to worry about. So we're going to pop our storage boxes down in this corner. We're not really concerned about them being too straight at the moment. And we're going to pop our extra mats that we want to keep into them. And some of that, and some of that, and them, and maybe some of them, and we'll see about making a campfire and getting some meat. So let's go and find some rocks. Always shut your door behind you. You never know what will be waiting inside for you. When you get back, if you don't. Hey, Mr. Track, are you stuck? Because, level four. Come on, hit that rock. That's it. Hello, compy. Goodbye, compy. I don't mind the compies in ones, but by golly, they're a bit annoying when they get into groups. And yeah, not following me. Okay. Campfire requires thatch and wood. And we're going to put it inside so that we can protect it if necessary. Oh, come on. And we're going to put some wood in it. And now we're going to go looking for. Actually, we need a spear, don't we? Spear needs flint and wood. Craft two, that's fine by me. Now I'll try and make a habit of craft one, that'll do fine. Hitting F to open boxes rather than hitting E, because E is your default action key, and you may not want to open or use whatever it is that you've just hit E with. And I'm sorry, Mr. Listro, but yeah. So yeah, I try and make a habit of hitting F to use containers and use machines and things, because it just means that I'm not getting on dinos and frustrating myself when I don't have to. We shall put the meat in there, and what does it take for a bed? Okie dokie, we need another couple of those and we'll be golden. And yes, I should take my own advice. Floating, random floating plant, cool. What level are you? 48, you might be a bit tough. Pego, you can sod off. And so can you. So basically, just looking for a dodo or something like that along the beach here. I'm just going to gamma up a bit because it is getting dark. But the light time. And there you go. Example Exhibit A. And he will have most of those berries. He can have them, it doesn't matter. But at least he's got something to the next one that comes along, if there's a next one. Hello, Mr. Dodo. Let's get some more fortitude going. Fortitude helps in that you may still see the freezing symbol come up when you're like in the cold, or the heat symbol where it's warmer areas, but you won't take damage and you won't. Oh well, bollocks. It won't, you know, damage you as much, so. Go. I think we've just about got enough hide, and we had wood, and we had. Gonna stick that meat in there. Take half the wood. Hide that fiber. What do we need for a bed? Bed, bed. Hello, bed. What do we need? Close. Go. That should do it. And I can hear you out there, Compy. I'm just not interested. Just trying to maximize our space. And there we go. We're going to finish that here. We have our first little starter hut. We have trained our first dino, or tamed our first dino. We have storage. We have a bed. And we will catch you on the next episode.